So it's becoming more and more unlikely that we're going to be able to just disconnect from social media completely. It's becoming more ingrained into our lives, into our businesses, and it's just becoming a way that people are communicating and interacting. And, you know, you can totally get off of social media if you feel like that's better for your mental health. At the same time, for some people, that may create a fear of missing out, or it may take away a form of connection that's really important for them. Social media isn't evil and it's not the enemy. You know, it's important to be aware of the risks and the effects of social media so that you can be more intentional with your time and really care for your mental health. So I have 12 tips to help you be more intentional with your social media use. Hey, I'm Tati. Welcome to Calmly Coping. I'm a licensed therapist and a high-functioning anxiety coach. And each episode, I talk about how to cope with anxiety as an overthinker so you can live a calmer, more fulfilling life. In this episode, I'm going to be talking about how to be more intentional with your social media usage, and that really affects your time. So if you're feeling overwhelmed, it's really important to check in with yourself and learn the skills so that you can be intentional with your time. You can learn all about this in my free guide, Goodbye Overwhelm, Your Guide to Accomplish More by Doing Less. In this guide, I take you step by step through the process of getting all of those overwhelming thoughts and what ifs out of your head and understanding what you need to prioritize in order to be the most effective with your time. You can download this guide at calmlycoping.com/overwhelm, or you can click on the link in the description below if you're watching on YouTube. Tip number one is becoming more aware of how often you use social media. So this means being aware of how often you check social media, what you're using it for, and how you feel afterwards. So how does going on social media, checking Instagram, going on Facebook, scrolling through Twitter, how does that affect your mood? Does it make you feel better? Does it make you feel worse? So really start to become more aware of the habits that you have in regards to social media and how that affects your life. Tip number two is to either use an app, or if you have an iPhone or other phone that you're able to track the amount of time that you spend on social media, use this and refer back to it. Social media can really be a time suck, and it's easy to get stuck scrolling through and just like having time fly by without you even realizing it. So that's when it can be important to really have that awareness of and look back and really analyze how much time am I spending on social media, and is this how you want to be spending your time? We all have the same number of hours in a day, and so if you're spending 3 hours, for example, scrolling through social media, could you be spending that time in a way doing things that you enjoy more? Maybe it's reading, maybe it's listening to a podcast, maybe it's having a conversation with a friend on the phone. So really looking at how much time you're spending on social media and thinking about if there are ways that you might want to spend that time differently. Number three, which may be a little more difficult in the era of coronavirus, but it's important to be present when you're interacting with somebody face to face. If possible, keep your phone out of sight, maybe in a pocket or in your purse, so that you're really able to be present. And the reason that I mention this with respect to social media is that oftentimes your phone can be a distraction that can actually take you away from that real person connection that's so important. Just being aware of how much time are you looking at your phone, are you checking social media when you're spending time with a friend or a family member, and how can you limit that so that you can truly be present with that person to get that connection that is so important. So another tip when it comes to social media is with regards to productivity and time management. So it's so easy when you're bored or when you're procrastinating to pick up your phone and to look through social media because you just don't want to do what you're working on. So I urge you to put your phone away when you're really trying to do focused work. So let's say if you've decided I need to work on prepping for this meeting or studying for this exam or writing this podcast outline, whatever it might be intentional and put your phone away. Even, try not to check social media on the browser so that you can really be more focused in your work And that's going to give you more time so that you can be more efficient and not distracted by the distractions, essentially, that social media brings up. Tip number 5 is important when it comes to sleep. So this is to put your phone, tablet, or computer in another room at night. So I don't know about you, but a lot of people that I know will spend their time before they go to bed at night scrolling through social media, or maybe if you're having trouble sleeping, you're going to wake up in the middle of the night and look through your phone. Although this might be entertaining in the moment, it can really affect your mental health without you realizing it. And so in the same ways that I spoke about earlier, it might cause you to feel more anxious. It might cause you to feel less confident, more frustrated, have negative impacts on your self-esteem, make you feel more lonely and sad. And so it's going to potentially exacerbate those feelings that you might already be having when you're lying in bed at night, unable to sleep. So a good tip is to keep your phone out of your room, put it away in a drawer even, and really focus on maybe reading a book or, you know, writing in a journal or even having the TV on, because these are other forms of coping skills and ways of entertainment that may not have as negative an effect on your mental health as checking social media might. So number 6 is, on a similar note, to disconnect from social media and from your phone about 30 minutes before bedtime. And so this is to help your brain quiet down from the night and start to relax. When you're interacting with others online or seeing what other people are doing or checking the news, all of these things are going to make it so it's harder for you to relax at night. Number 7 is to block certain app notifications or turn them off entirely, whatever it is for your piece of technology. So this can be helpful because it can be really distracting if you're getting notified by Instagram every time you get a like or every time you get a DM or a comment. And, you know, is it really necessary for you to be notified every time this happens? So, you know, that's just something for you to think about. And I think it can be really effective to just turn these notifications off completely so that you're not getting distracted throughout your day. Tip number 8 is to set aside certain times of the day to check social media. So again, checking social media can become a time suck and a distraction. And so one way to be more intentional is to maybe set aside 10 minutes in the morning, 10 minutes in the afternoon, 10 minutes in the evening, or, you know, whatever amount of time fits your desire, your lifestyle, so that you're not getting sucked into that endless scrolling and distraction. Tip number 9 is to delete social media apps from your phone completely. Now, I know this can be scary if you're so used to having easy access to checking social media all the time. This has really worked for me. So I have absolutely no social media on my cell phone. And I have my Instagram app on my iPad, and I also have Twitter on there, and I don't even have the Facebook app. I just check that in the browser. This really works for me because I have made that choice to really be present when I'm out and about and not thinking about what can I do to post this on Instagram. I'm not saying that that's a bad thing to do, but that's what's really worked for me. And so, you know, it helps me to be more present and not on my phone when I'm out of my house and not connected to Wi-Fi, so that I can really focus on being present and experiencing what's going on around me. So this can be a really good behavioral tip because deleting the app makes it harder to check. And so you might find yourself checking less frequently because it's harder to go to your browser and log on to Facebook than it is to just click on the Facebook app. So try deleting it, even if it's just for a limited amount of time, and see if that changes your behavior and changes the amount of time you spend on social media. So tip number 10 is to buy an alarm clock or a watch. And so the reason I suggest this, because it might sound like it's unrelated, is that oftentimes, you know, people use their cell phone as an alarm. And then let's say you turn off your alarm and then you automatically go and check social media. Or you're going to check the time and you're checking your phone and like you didn't even realize what time it was before you put your phone away because you got sucked into checking social media. So if you have these other forms of doing these tasks that are going to take you away from checking your phone, it can help to prevent you from getting sucked into that distraction. So tip number 11 is similar in that you would buy a digital camera. And so I find this tip helpful as well, because instead of taking pictures with my phone and getting distracted by maybe responding to messages or whatever it is, I'm using a digital camera to focus on just taking photos and not getting distracted by all of the other things that come up on your phone. And tip number 12, which is kind of like a ninja level tip, is to take a social media detox. So this can be even just taking one day a week where you don't check social media at all. I think that this can be really helpful to give you that disconnection from the online world and really help to put you into experiencing the moment and reconnecting with and checking in with yourself. Be fully present in your life, not the internet, and notice the difference that that makes for you. I know these were a lot of tips, so even if you can only implement one of these tips into your life, it can have a big impact on your mood and your mental health. To wrap up, today I talked about 12 tips to be more intentional with your usage of social media. So your action tip, if you notice that social media can have a negative impact on your mood, then try and use one of those 12 tips or more that I shared in this episode and see if that helps make a difference. If you found this podcast episode informative, please screenshot yourself listening to it or watching it and share it to your Instagram stories, tagging me at TatianaGLPC. Please don't forget to subscribe if you're watching this on YouTube and hit the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post a new episode. I release new episodes every Wednesday. And please subscribe if you are listening to the podcast. Until next time. Be calm.